This video is brought to you by BossRootin.com and PowerPerformanceProducts.com, where you can receive $10 off your purchase of Body Storm and Body Effects.
Spencer Lazara, MMAInterviews.tv. I'm here with Mark Munoz, the wrecking machine. You got another little wrecking machine that we saw, really his, you know, in the limelight tonight here for National Fight Alliance, Caleb Valentin.
That's right, man. He's got the heart. He's got the heart of a lion, and he loves it. He loves competing. He's been competing ever since he's been five years old. He's been wrestling, and, you know, wrestlers just have, they have what it takes, you know. And, you know, when you tell him something, he does it, and he's got that plus one attitude. You tell him to do something, he does it, then he does another thing on top of that, you know. It's just, I mean, he's the work ethic that he displays, it's amazing. Kids like that, man, you can't help but love, you know. So I can't wait to just nurture that and for him to just shine, man, just like he did tonight.
Clearly the perfect camp for him to be at with guys like you and Jake, spiritual, quiet, respectful competitors who get in there and just on another level, though, when they get in there. You know, do you think it's a perfect fit?
He's a perfect fit. And he actually moved from Northern California to Southern California. And he's like, "Coach, I wanna fight for you." And I'm like, "Hey, man, you know, I coached him in high school at different camps." He was gonna transfer from Oregon State to Fullerton, where I was helping out. You know, so he's got a bright future, and I'm very, very excited for him, man. So I'm at loss for words right now, because that kid, he's just been through a lot, man. He's been through a lot, and he deserves everything that he's getting right now.
It's nice to see you. I notice you really give back to your guys. I mean, you're up here at the highest level, the UFC and everything. You really give back, and you're building a team, you mentioned. I got a ton of guys like this.
Yeah, I got a lot of guys like him, man. I really do. And I'm excited because just the camaraderie that we share, the team that we share, it's amazing the type of guys that we pull in. And even the guys that were kind of rough around the edges, they assimilate around to what we want as an individual. So it's awesome to be able to have an environment like we have over at Rain Training Center, and the guys over there are just amazing. And without them, we wouldn't be able to perform inside the cage like we do. So we need those guys, and they need us. And so it's you know, there's a verse in the Bible where it says, as iron sharpens iron, so one man's countenance sharpens another man's countenance. You know, and we sharpen one another, not only in the cage, but also outside. You know, and that's what it's all about. We keep each other accountable. Character is huge. And you know, that's what we're all about, man. We want to be successful on all levels, not just inside the cage, but all levels in our life.
Okay. Let's move on to the UFC stuff now. How's your elbow, I guess, first off?
It's getting better. See, it's almost straight. It's almost straight.
So you got a fight announced, Chris Weidman, correct?
Yeah. Is it announced?
Seems like a rumor and announced. I don't know, you tell me.
No, I mean, I don't think it's announced. It's not announced because there's a lot of rumors floating around, but, you know, I just want somebody that's gonna give me a title shot, you know?
Are you disappointed with all the talk with Bisping, maybe, that's not the fight you got, since it looks like he got a different fight?
Yeah, he got Boach, man. He got Boach. So, and he said that Boach is a better fight than me, which is not the case at all, you know? Personally, man, I've done everything I can to get a title shot, and I'm going to keep campaigning for that. And I'm not a guy that's gonna, you know, talk a lot of trash. You know, I'm not like that. I let my actions take control inside the octagon, and you know, I'm not gonna compromise who I am as a person to be able to, you know, get what I want. You know, although you know, I need to be more vocal than, you know, a lot of my coaches told me I need, and my managers, I need to be more vocal, and I will. You know, I will. But at the same time, I'm gonna let my fights do the talking.
So is Weidman, I mean, that's a good matchup theoretically, though, a guy like that.
Yeah, Weidman's great, man. He wrestled at Hofstra. I mean, he's got a good base as far as wrestling, and he's an up and coming kid. And yeah, I mean, that would be a great fight. You know, you know, whoever I fight, you know, I'm just going to have the mentality, I'm just going to put it on them.
When would you expect to get back in the Octagon?
I'd say probably around July or August.
August, Staples Center seems like a good home, right?
That'd be awesome. That'd be awesome to fight local. It would.
What do you think about Anderson Silva and Chael Sonnen going down? What are your thoughts on that?
I think it's the biggest fight in MMA history, the rematch. And in Brazil, home turf, it's kind of hostile territory for Chael. It's interesting to see what type of security they're going to have for him there. A lot of people want his head. But, yeah, the fight itself, it's going to be great. The fight itself, you're going to watch Anderson do a lot of new things, I bet. He won't have struggles or adversity with his ribs like he did in the first fight. Both guys are my friends. You know what I mean? I get managed by the same manager. Chael is managed, and Anderson is a good friend of mine, you know? So it's just, you know, I want to see a good fight. You know, that's plain and simple. And, you know, I want my turn. You know, I want my turn.
Can't pick a winner for us then?
No, I can't. I just want a good fight.
Okay. How about Rashad and Jones? Can we get a winner out of that one?
In a breakdown?
Man, I think if Rashad can stay in Jones's face, he's going to do very well. If Jones is able to utilize his length, and if Rashad gets in close and he utilizes his takedowns as Rashad's punching, he has a great chance too. I'm friends with both guys, you know. So, but I see it being a great fight. I see Rashad, you know, being that pit bull that he is, and going in there and like doing everything he can to keep the fight, you know, within range for him. For John Jones, I see him doing unconventional elbows, knees, kicks. I see him doing that stuff and utilizing his wrestling too. But then again, they were training partners, so they know each other quite well. So it's going to be whoever transitions. The winner's going to be the one who transitions well into, you know, striking and wrestling. That's what I think.
So. What are your thoughts on, obviously, Alistair Overeem? And maybe, I know it doesn't really tie in, but testosterone therapy.
I think it's cheating. I think it's cheating. I think anything that's synthetic that you put in your body is cheating. Get it from food, you know, get it from training. That stuff jacks you up when you're done. You know, I mean, for me, I'm a family man. I have kids, I have a wife, and I want to be there for them at the end. I think when you take PEDs or anything like that, it cuts your life short. And when it becomes like that, it's almost hedonistic. It's not a sport anymore. You know what I'm saying? Like it becomes more than a sport, and it shouldn't be like that, man. There's more important things in your life than that. You know what I'm saying? So. I frown upon that. I don't like to ever see it. And, you know, the truth is that it is present, you know, and you can't hide it because it comes out. But then again, I can stand in front of you 100% saying that I've never taken a drug in my life, and I'm going to keep doing that, and I'm going to win like that. And if people think I'm on drugs or PEDs or whatever, come train with me. I'll show you my drugs, you know, because there's no substitution for hard work.
That's awesome, man. Mark Munoz, you want to train with him, check him out. Rain Training Center down there in Lake Forest. I'm sure he'll give you a free butt kicking if you come in there. So appreciate the time. Anything else you want to say, Mark?
Yeah, if you guys want to check our website out, it's traintorain.com. That's T-R-A-I-N, the number 2, rain, R-E-I-G-N.com. You can follow me on Twitter, too, at Mark_Munoz, behind Twitter.com/. Facebook too. You can follow me on my fan page. So, thank you for all your support, guys. And I'm going to continue to try to represent as much as I can.
Can't wait to see you back in the Octagon. Mark Munoz, I'm Spencer Lazari. You're watching MMAinterviews.tv.
Godspeed and party on.